You're listening to Lexi on the Mic. This week has been very emotional for me. If you know me, you know that I am Kobe's, now I don't want to say number one, but I am probably one of his most obsessive fans. The fan that has probably tried to buy every t-shirt, has watched every interview, has rewatched all the games. I am that type of fan. Like I knew too much about him personally. I knew too much of his rituals that he would do. It was ridiculous how much I knew about someone I had never even met a day in my life. But I didn't care. I loved him. I rooted for him. I fought for him. I argued for him. I would do everything for Kobe Bryant, Kobe Bean Bryant, till the death of me. I was at my part-time job. My phone was blowing up, but I was at work, so I was ignoring it. And then they call the store, and it's my dad, and he said, Kobe died. And I just laughed, and I just, no, he's not. Like, what are you talking about? He said, his helicopter crashed. And I said, no, it didn't. Like, okay, if it crashed, like, he's probably just in the hospital injured. Like, you can't read what he said online. And the first thing I said was, did ESPN report anything? And he said, no. So then I instantly thought, okay, then nothing's wrong with him. Kobe's fine, or he's just in the hospital and he's injured. But there was no way that Superman, the Black Mamba, was dead. And then I got an alert. And then I got even more phone calls and more texts and more tags and more videos sent to me. And it was just too overwhelming. This was literally the joke that people would tell me sometimes just to see how I would react. So to finally hear it and to see that it was real, I still to this day don't believe it. And then when I was home and you find out about Gigi and you find out about the teammates and you find out about the other family and the coach and you find out about all these people who now are leaving all their loved ones. And it goes beyond him. Like, yes, Kobe was such an amazing basketball player, an amazing person, and what he was going to do for women's basketball, no one will ever know. But the impact that him and Gigi were already starting to make on it was remarkable. I just can't even begin to really wrap my head around it, because then you have to wrap your head around how did all those people feel getting that phone call, knowing that their loved one was not coming back. And all they were doing was just going to a basketball tournament like they'd done every other weekend. It was just a normal day, a normal Sunday, and your whole world gets flipped upside down in a matter of a 15-minute helicopter ride. I can't force myself to really sit down and feel everything, because it's too much. You're feeling for too many people, too many emotions, too many heartbreaks. But the best thing that has come out of this is that I've gotten hate for so long about being a Kobe and being a Laker fan. And you now see all the love for his family, for him, for his legacy, for all his hard work. And not just him, but people are also sharing their all those other lives that were lost. People are putting out stories about them. Like, to see all the love that has been shown around the world is remarkable. And it's truly overwhelming at times. And I think something that has taught me is that I was so devoted and so dedicated to my work for so long, and my life became something I knew unknown, and I didn't know how to handle that. I don't know what's going to happen next, but I know that I gave up. I know that I saw my life worth not living anymore. I know I didn't see the future. I just saw what was happening to me in that moment and where I was at, and I just felt stuck. And I lost that Mamba mentality that I had growing up. And I don't think I can live like this anymore. I think I have to fight to get my Mamba mentality back, fight to get out of this hole, fight for the dream, go back to how I was and find myself again, more now than ever. Because if I was to walk out my house one morning and something tragic was to happen to me, this is not the way I would want to go out. I would not be happy with how everything had played out. And I don't know how I would be able to live myself if I didn't. And that's just another thing. Like, some of those girls, their life had just started. They just found the love for basketball. They just found their dream school. They were just starting. Their story was just being written. And I've had a story for 25 years now, and I can't stop writing it. I have to keep going. Some chapters are probably going to be sad and boring and just too much, but then the next one will be great and be filled with love and happiness and laughter. And I think now more than ever, I just want to go see people I haven't seen in years. I want to rekindle friendships that ended over dumb shit. I want to travel. I want to go to more and more concerts. I want to live life to the fullest now, because someone who I saw was invisible. He was untouchable. If there was ever going to plane going, a plane that was going to crash, I saw him jumping out of one and landing it and being okay. He was untouchable in my eyes. And now I will never see him shoot a basketball. I'll never hear one of his podcasts. I'll never read another one of his books. And I'll never see his daughter play for my favorite team. I was a fan. And I was a Bryant fan. I was the Bryant family fan. Not just a Kobe fan. I was the whole family's fan. I think this has all taught me you just gotta live in the moment. We can't stress about what's gonna happen next week or the next day. You can only control the moment you're in. And just don't take advantage of the people in your life. Even if people left your life and they left for stupid reasons, and you know that there was something real, fight for them back. Get them back. Reach out. What's going to hurt? They ignoring your text? Okay. You tried. Just surrounding yourself with loved ones right now is the true happiness we all need. I've seen so many videos and so many pictures and images that people have created or people are coming up with, dedicating it to him, about him and his daughter and about his legacy. And I could only think of one way. He loved to write. He wrote a letter to us as fans when he retired. He wrote a letter to basketball when he retired. So why don't I just write a letter to him? So what I did was I took his Dear Basketball, his retirement letter, and I changed it to Dear Kobe. Here it is.
Dear Kobe, from the moment I started cheering for the Lakers and shooting imaginary game-winning shots in the Staples Center, I fell in love with you. I gave you my loyalty from my mind and body to my spirit and soul. As an 11-year-old girl, deeply in love with the game, I never saw the end of the tunnel. I only saw you running out of one. And so you ran. You ran up and down every court, after every loose ball. We asked for your hustle, and you gave us your heart, because it came with so much more. You played through the sweat and hurt, not because the challenge called you, but we called you. You did everything for us, because that's what you do when you make someone feel as alive as you made all of us feel. You gave an 11-year-old girl her true Laker idol, and I will always love you for that. And I will continue to love you obsessively as long as I live on. My heart can take the pounding, my mind can handle the grind, but I will never say goodbye. And that's okay. No one is ready to let you go. We will savor every game-winning shot, every championship, and 81 points. The good and the bad, we gave each other all that we had. And we both know, no matter what I do next, I'll always be the kid wearing her Kobe shirt in front of her TV screen, 5 seconds on the clock, ball in Black Mama's hands. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Now it's time for Word on the Street. Liz McGuire and the Proud family will be making their return to Disney Plus. So if you don't have it, you need to get it, because those are my two favorite Disney Channel shows. Next to Hannah Montana. Adele has been breaking necks. Recently, she has been spotted out on vacation with Harry Styles. Ooh, but she is slaying in her new body. She has lost 43 pounds and is making it look like she is living her best life. The album 30 is about to be ridiculous. Who knows what Adele we are going to get this time, ladies and gentlemen. And speaking of music, Justin Bieber has finally returned. Oh, Oh my gosh, he has been teasing us for months about making music or just anything. Everyone thought it was going to be a Christmas album at one point, but little do we know, he's dropping a whole album. He dropped the latest single called Yummy, and now he's going on tour, and, which I will not be missing that tour, by the way, and he has a YouTube documentary series out now. Oh my gosh, I am in like believer heaven right now. On January 10th, his former lover, Selena Gomez, is dropping her long-awaited album, Rare. Woo, Selena versus Justin, who's gonna have the better album?
Now it's time for my top five. First up, we have the one and only Lil Wayne with no other song than Kobe Bryant. Next up is Mustard featuring Roddy Ricch with Ballin'. Next up is Ava Max on Somebody. Don't Call to Come Back, he's been here for years. Here's Justin Bieber with Yummy. Yummy, yum, yummy, yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, 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 yummy. Last but not least, here is Jimmy Allen with How to Be Single. I don't wanna have to wait 2 days and wonder, should I call, should I text, guessing who's gonna hit who up next, yeah. I don't wanna be cool, I don't wanna be clever, try to talk somebody into leaving together. I don't wanna get drunk, I don't wanna mangle, I don't wanna know how to be single. That's all I got for you today. You're listening to Lexi on the Mic.